Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Kristen here, and it is almost time for Holiday Booktubeathon! The winter edition of Booktubeathon this year is going to run from December 29th till December 31st, and as always, it is hosted by Ariel Bassett, as well as some other lovely booktubers. I will leave a link to Ariel's kickoff video in the description section below. The winter edition of Booktubeathon is always a lot shorter and more casual. There are not going to be video challenges, but there will be lots of prizes and giveaways, as well as Twitter sprints, which are my favorite anyway. Before I share with you the reading challenges and my personal TBR, make sure you subscribe to the channel if you haven't done that yet. I am trying to reach a goal of 500 subscribers, and I would be very excited if you would help me reach that goal. And also, if you enjoyed the video at the end, give it a thumbs up to let me know. The books that I read completely depend on the mood that I'm in. I kind of have to have a big TBR pile going into the readathon so that I can pick and choose from a lot of different options, because I never know what I'm gonna feel like reading on the day. Reading challenge number one: read a book that has your favorite color on the cover. My favorite color has been blue since I was a little kid, so I scoured my TBR shelf for a book with blue on the cover, and what do you know? The Rose and the Dagger by Renee Ostia is beautiful periwinkle blue, and I actually read the first book in this duology, The Wrath and the Dawn, during the summer Booktubeathon. This would actually be a really fitting book for me to read this winter as part of the Booktubeathon. However, it is a little bit on the long side, so I may have to pick something else instead of this. Reading challenge number two is read a book from a genre you discovered this year. Now, I am a speculative fiction type of girl. I love fantasy, paranormal, science fiction. However, I read a couple of contemporaries this year that made me want to look for more contemporaries to check out. So for this challenge, I am going to try out another contemporary. I may read Memoirs of a Teenage Amnesiac by Gabrielle Zevin. And just as a side note, let me point out that the text on this cover is blue. So if I need this book to meet multiple challenges, I might be doing that. And the other contemporary I've been thinking about is P.S. I Like You by Casey West. This was in, I believe it was an Owlcrate box a couple of months ago, and the cover is really cute, and I've heard the story is very sweet, and it's an easy, quick read, which is good for a readathon. And the third reading challenge is read a book that was gifted to you. Now, I actually don't receive a lot of books as gifts. I think it's because I tend to buy books for myself on a whim all the time, and nobody wants to take the chance that they buy me something I already own. I had to get a little creative with this one. So my first thought was that books you receive in your book subscription boxes are kind of like gifts. Somebody else picks the book out for you, you open it up like a special little package, and you don't know what's inside, just like a gift. So P.S. I Like You, which once again came in the Owlcrate subscription box, might meet this challenge. Also, I might read Alice in Wonderland by Lewis Carroll, and this was in Owlcrate's November Wonderland themed box. This is a nice short read, which would be a great pick for me for a readathon. I actually also just finished reading Heartless by Marissa Meyer, which is the origin story of the Queen of Hearts, so I think going back and rereading Alice in Wonderland with that different perspective about this world might be kind of fun. When you receive an ARC in the mail, that is kind of like a special little gift in itself also. And if you don't know, that stands for Advanced Review Copy, Care of All by Stephanie Garber, which releases in January, so I probably should be reading this one at the end of December. However, it's a little bit long. I also have Gilded Cage, which is by Vic James, a lot shorter. I don't know if I'll be reading either one of these or neither of these. We'll just have to wait and see. The final Booktubeathon challenge is to read 3 books. It will be a miracle if I'm able to read 3 books in 3 days. I have never been able to really do that before. If I pick short books, I might be able to get it done. Those are the reading challenges and my TBR for the winter holiday edition of Booktubeathon. If you're participating, make sure you let me know in the comment section below. And if you were thinking about reading any of the books that I just talked about, let me know that too, because I love to do buddy reads during readathons. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you guys soon with another video. Bye!